in your life. You are involved in doing stupid things, and by the side, the life goes on slipping out of your hands. You will realize it only at the time of death. Always in the future, and life is always here. The goal is always far away, and life is in this very moment. Trying to achieve it, you will miss it. Life.
see only the manifestations, yet mystery and manifestations arise from the same source. This source is called darkness. Darkness within darkness, the gateway to all understanding. The supreme good is like water, which nourishes all things without trying to. It is content with the low places that people disdain. Thus, it is like the Tao. In dwelling, live close to the ground. In thinking, keep to the simple. In conflict, be fair and generous. In governing, do not try to control. In work, do what you enjoy. In family life, be completely present. When you are content to be simply yourself and do not compare or compete, everybody will respect you. Fill your bowl to the brim, and it will spill. Keep sharpening your knife, and it will blunt. Chase after money and security, and your heart will never unclench. Care about people's approval, and you will be their prisoner. Do your work, then step back. The only path to serenity. The Tao is like a well, used but never used up. It is like the eternal void, filled with infinite possibilities. It is hidden, but always present. I do not know who gave birth to it. It is older than God.
Say in your mind, say to yourself, I am more than my physical body, because I am more than physical matter. I deeply desire to expand, to experience, to know, to understand, to control, to use such greater energies and energy systems as may be beneficial and constructive to me and to those near and close to me. Also, I deeply desire the help and cooperation, the assistance, the understanding of those individuals whose wisdom, development, and experience are equal or greater than my own.
Where did you come from, bright star? What heaven did you leap from, dear love? How can I spell your name without the sound of autumn underneath my tongue? Without acknowledging the lovers who bent me and half blessed them for bringing me to you? How can I say your name without also breathing the words, my God, I found you? How can I ever speak again with this mouth when it has found where it belongs? When you touch me, I am a bed of calla lilies. I will make a house for you and fill it with evergreens. I will paint sunsets on every wall so you can only see beautiful things. How can I say love without wanting to fold myself into you like a thousand paper cranes, dear one? I was halved the moment I was born. Yet a piece of me is inside of your mouth. And I was found whole the moment you spoke.
Thank you. the dark calls to you sometimes, but you turn your face from the light. I know you walk down roads you know you shouldn't, walk into places your heart is gently urging you not to. I know you see your habits and long to change them. I know you are tired of your worn out ways of being, tired of reliving patterns and choosing painful choices. I know you feel hollow at times, like life is escaping you, dancing in front of you but out of your reach somehow. I know it hurts to live in the disconnect between what you are currently experiencing and what you know exists outside of you, beautifully, without effort. I know how much it hurts to live there, in the divide between what you feel you are and what you wish you could be. I know you have tasted the sun on your skin and inhaled with complete trust, and that you too at times find it hard to move without knowing what's next. That at times life feels paralyzing. I know you work so hard to control the outcome of your life that you forget to breathe sometimes. That you live in the shallow end. That you forget to go deep, breathe deep. That you forget to meet yourself in the quiet and breathe yourself full again. That you forget there is a well of abundance and trust within you. That you forget to go there for fear of losing control. I know there are places within yourself that you do not love. The parts you try to wrestle away. I know they're there within you and that they steal away your joy. I know you visit them from time to time, hoping they have somehow disappeared. I know you travel between internal peace and trust and terror and fear. I know you long to live more in bliss, where you know you were intended to live. I know you can feel it vibrating in your cells when you arrive there in the grace of bliss, that this is where you belong. Or when you arrive there, you are so alive, it's as if everything around you is telling you, yes, you are home. But I know too that shadows come and pull at your feet. That they come sometimes while you are asleep and drag you down into the familiar landscape of fear and doubt. I know you journey there too from time to time, wondering if the light will ever return. Or you fear you'll never outgrow this dance between the two worlds. I know you can see how much you have grown, that you are learning to taste heaven, that you swear sometimes you could grow wings, that you believe life is in your favor, that you are rising above your dark shadows, that you are becoming free. I know you live there, in the tear between these two worlds, between the dark and the light, between trust and distrust, between love and hatred, between acceptance and resistance, between control and faith, between sun-soaked mornings and dark forests. You are human, my dear one. My dearest love, you are human. You are allowed to be in both ways. You are allowed. You are not wrong. You are not damaged. You are not failing because you still get lost in dark rivers. You are human. Be gentle when doubt comes, when fear chokes, when control debilitates, when loneliness blinds you. Spend special care to love yourself in these dark corridors of your being. Spend special care to bring love to your own self, to take gentle care of your vulnerability when you are here. When you arrive in the dark, Know you are being offered the chance to grow your own internal garden of love. That the dark offers you the chance to love all of the places you never dare, all of the places that challenge you, all of the places you curse. That the dark offers a restoration of love to your entire being, no matter what land you stand in. When you are down, you deserve more love, not less. Where we deprive ourselves of love is where we need it most. When the dark comes, tell it what it longs so deeply to hear. That you are loved. That you are loved in all of your shadow and loved in all of your light. That you are loved in all of your various stages. Moments of fear or sadness cannot be cured or defeated. They can only be transformed by learning to love and support yourself when they arrive. It will come again and again, giving you the opportunity to cultivate your own inner garden of love, and with time and practice, it will release. It will visit less. It will come not for days, but instead only moments. It will remind you from time to time to love yourself more. The dark, it serves you. You are learning to restore the love you lost, the love you forgot you were comprised of. When the light comes, as it always does, even if only found for a moment on the crest of a wave, on a southern breeze, on a beat of dew, know that it is sending you its own unique message of love, confirming that you, without any effort on your part, are being blessed. You are being showered. That the universe is a kind and loving one. That even in the great darkness that visits you, you are being taught how to love. And close your eyes now. Feel the rise and fall of your chest. Feel the darkness behind your lids. See, here in this place lives also great light. They are part of one another. They hold the same message. They have the same intention. Place your hand on your heart. And whisper, I love you. Give yourself permission to be in all the places you are, without judgment or criticism or frustration. And let the process of life unfold as it is. Change nothing about it. Except for the amount of love you shower yourself with. Except for the amount of love you give to yourself. In both times of great joy and great unrest. Thank you.
think I'm gonna go hungry.
Is leaking everywhere. The universe is a sphere whose center is everywhere, whose circumference is nowhere. The world is a sphere whose center is everywhere.
Thank you. Time in your life when you will ask yourself a series of questions. Am I happy with who I am?
Am I happy with who I am?
Am I happy with the people around me?
Am I happy with the people around me?
Am I happy with what I'm doing?
Am I happy with what I'm doing?
Am I happy with the way my life is going?
Am I happy with the way my life is going?
Do I have a life?
Do I have a life?
Or am I just living?
Or am I just living?
Do not let these questions restrain or trouble you. Just point yourself in the direction of your dreams. Find your strength in the sound and make your transition.
Make your transition.
Make your transition.
Make your transition.
Make your
transition.
Make your transition.
Make your transition.
Make your transition.
Make your transition. Do I spend too much time thinking and not enough doing? Did I try my hardest at any of my dreams? did I purposely let others discourage me when I knew I could?
When I knew I could.
Will I die?
Will I die?
Never knowing what I could have been
or could have
done.
Or could have done.
Do not let these doubts restrain or trouble you.
No, dejes esas preguntas.
Just point yourself in the direction of your dreams.
En la dirección de tus sueños.
Find your strength in the sound
and
make your transition.
Y haga tu transición.
Make your transition.
Haga tu transición.
Make your transition.
Haga tu transición.
There will be people who will say you can't. But you will.
You will.
You will.
There will be people who will say you don't mix this with that. And you will say, watch me.
Watch me.
There will be people who will say, play it safe. That's too risky. And you will take that chance and have no fear.
No fear.
No fear.
You won't let these questions restrain or trouble you. You will point yourself in the direction of your dreams. You will find the strength in the sound and make your transition. Make your transition.
Haga tu transición.
Make your transition.
Haga tu transición.
Make your transition.
Haga tu transición.
For those who know, it's time to leave the house and go back to the field. Find your strength in the sound.
Encuentre fuerza en el
sonido. It's what got us through in the first place. Find your strength in the sound and make your transition.
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 No dejes estas preguntas preocuparte. Nomás púntate en la dirección de tus sueños. Encuentra fuerza en el sonido y haga tu transición. Haga tu transición. Haga tu transición.
Haga tu transición.
We will focus on the chakras and their representative sounds. I will play the Tibetan bowls that correspond to each chakra. I will share affirmations for each chakra. Relax into these sounds as we focus on the energies in each of these areas. We will start with the root chakra. Focus on the area at the base of the spine. Feel the energy in this area. To be rooted is our right to be. You are worthy to simply be. To be grounded is the solidification of insight, embodiment of concepts in a grounded form. You are worthy to simply be. You are worthy to bring things into being. I choose love, not fear, in every moment. I am safe here, and my needs are met. Sacral chakra. Focus in the area of the pelvis and sexual glands. Feel your energy in this area. Let go of guilt, shame, oppression. You are free to express yourself in love. I am open to giving. it is these loving energies that create life and receiving. This is a divine celebration of love. All morality is self-respect. I am open to giving and receiving life-giving and life-creating pleasures based in selfless love. Solar plexus. Focus in the area of the gut. Feel your energy in this area. When is your will tested? It is not personal will, but the will of life, the creative spirit of life that guides right action. You do not have to exert stress. You do not have to force achievement. Simply take action with the intention of love. Feel the energy of right intent. My will to act is powered by my intention to love. Heart chakra. Focus your energy in the center of the chest, in the area of heart energy. Open your heart. Let down the walls of criticism, judgment, unforgiveness, and anger.
I release my defenses.
Forgive yourself and love yourself in spite of your perceived imperfections. Forgive others and love others as they are. We are worthy to simply give love and receive love. Accept yourself as you are, so that you can accept others as they are. Feel the openness. Feel the burden you are letting go. It's okay to love without judgment. It's okay to love without conditions. Be the love that you seek. I release my defenses. I open my heart to the world. Throat chakra. Focus your attention in the area of the throat. Feel the energy in this area. Are you able to speak your truth? Are you able to speak your intention with clarity?
I speak.
There is no barrier to the truth. Express your boundaries.
Speak my truth.
Express what is okay with you and what is not. Speak new circumstances, healthy relationships, and healthy boundaries into being. This is your power. I speak my truth in clarity and love. Third eye chakra. Focus your energy in the area between the brows. This is where the energy of intuition flows. This is the third eye, the truth beyond perception.
I see the truth of love.
See the truth. It's okay to see the truth. You can let go of the armor that has led to self-deception.
I see the truth.
You can now see yourself in clarity and forgiveness. Your willingness to see yourself clearly will allow you to see others in the outside world more clearly. This will allow others to see you clearly too. The present moment is the place of clarity and authenticity. Know yourself. By letting go of my agenda and the concerns of my personal identity and ego, I see the truth of love clearly in this present moment. Crown chakra. Focus your energy in the ring around the top of your head. divine energy of life flows into your being from this space. There is no future or past in this flow, only pure awareness. This is your connection to the present moment, love, and divine presence. The I am is love. Feel your connection to the divine beyond identity. In the I am is the way. The I am is life. The I am is infinite. I am infinitely connected to the spirit of love. The life-giving force of love is present in all things. The I am is love.
Breathe normally and relax. Relax and breathe normally. Say in your mind, say to yourself, I am more than my physical body. Because I am more than physical matter, I deeply desire to expand, to experience, to know, to understand, to control, to use such greater energies and energy systems as may be beneficial and constructive to me and to those near and close to me. Also, I deeply desire the help and cooperation, the assistance, the understanding of those individuals whose wisdom, development, and experience are equal or greater than my own.
Upset boomed, things broke, we broke, we hurt, and we yelled in anguish to the world around us. When we felt our deepest heartache, no one said we were allowed to simply feel all of it. Instead, we were taught to hide, deny, and abandon ourselves, to condemn the pain instead of comfort it. We ignored our feelings and hampered our body's inborn process of healing. No one knew any better. But now we know that our bodies are here to speak to us. In our upset, our bodies are asking for loving attention, not abandonment. So let's work on allowing our feeling intelligence its rightful place in our body. Let us give ourselves permission to thaw our frozen emotions and seeming fragility. Let us give vulnerability a throne and a voice. Let's give ourselves back to ourselves, listening to our needs and finding freedom by honoring our brilliant an intricate system of sensitivity. I'd like you to close your eyes, coming to feel your body breathing, to feel your aliveness. Look for the gentle current of grace running through your body and allow yourself to enter this grace. Allow yourself to become one with this grace, becoming more and more available and receptive to your spirit, to your heart, to yourself.